Yep, yep.
Uh-huh. Oh no.
Matt and Daisy, do you want to talk about your recipes while I blow my nose? Yeah.
Hi everyone, welcome back to this, the spiciest episode of Chemists in the Kitchen yet.
We're gonna look at how we can transfer heat from chili peppers and other things into our food.
And how we can cool this spiciness down.
So kick back, get your milk, and be ready to go. Hi, my name is Matt Hartings. I'm an associate professor of chemistry at American University, and I do both materials chemistry, where I make new things for 3D printing, and also a food chemist.
Hi, my name is Robin Mays. I'm a chemical engineer by training. I study plastics, how their properties affect their behavior.
Hi, my name is Daisy Rosas Vargas. I am an assistant professor of chemistry at Ithaca College, and I am an organic metallic chemist by training, but I really just like teaching.
So today we're talking about how we get the hotness into our food or away from our mouths if things are too hot. Let's take some crushed red pepper, for example, right? You take this, you eat it, you put it in your mouth, it's super spicy, right? It burns your mouth. And so today we're talking about how we can get that spiciness into our food and the things that we need to do to make that happen.
So after we go through all of our recipes and set our mouths on fire, we're gonna need to put out that fire. So we're gonna talk about the chemistry of how to choose what to eat after something spicy to return your temperature to normal. So I'm the chemist here representing those who are maybe not such a fan of spicy food. I'm going to be going with the spiciness, but I'm also going to be talking to the non-spicy folks.
I really like spicy food, and you know, maybe that's white person spicy and not real spicy, like someone who eats Thai food all the time. But I do enjoy spicy food.
So I'm the chemist that really, really likes spicy food. It's actually part of my culture. And my grandmother has actually made me my own, like, chili paste, and I have carried this at least for the last 5 years.
Today I'm making a fried chili paste. So this recipe, you start off by steeping the oil with a bunch of really aromatic ingredients. So when I do this, I'm going to use garlic and shallots and star anise and cloves, Sichuan peppercorns. And you steep it for an hour in oil just to pull out lots of really amazing flavors. So you take that really hot oil and pour it over a bunch of chili flakes, and it extracts all of these great spices from the chilies as well. What you end up with is this really amazing, both fragrant and spicy condiment to put on whatever you want.
Okay, so today I'm gonna be making muhammara, which is a red pepper dip that's originally from Aleppo. So this dip is walnuts, red peppers, breadcrumbs, pomegranate molasses, Aleppo pepper, and then some spices. So this is not normally a super spicy dip, but I am gonna maybe experiment with some less and more spicy peppers to see what happens.
I'm going to be making chili infused honey. And so I'm gonna take dried chili peppers. So these could be like ancho chili peppers or guajillo or just regular dried chili peppers. And I'm going to steep them in some honey and then just warm that honey up so I can get all that spicy capsaicin into the honey. And this goes very well with teas when you're sick or even with summer cocktails.
So this is what muhammara looks like when it's made. It's kind of a thick red paste. Super easy recipe to make. It's basically all in the food processor. And the non-spicy part of the recipe is roasted red peppers. Traditional pepper that's used in this, it's Aleppo pepper. So it's kind of like a very finely chopped crushed red pepper. So I'm gonna try with the Aleppo pepper and heat that in oil, but I'm also gonna try with the hottest peppers I had in my cabinet, which are some ghost peppers that my dad grew. So we'll see. You'll get to see me cry on camera is what's gonna happen.
just remember, it's the seeds are not the things that are spicy. It's actually the veins, and they call the central white part the placenta. So that's what really has like 89% of the capsaicin.
We have all of these receptors in our mouths, right, that tell us about the world around us. We also have pain receptors in our mouths. One of those pain receptors is called TRPV1. And so it's just a protein in your mouth. When capsaicin interacts with that protein, the protein kind of opens up and it lets ions in and out. That's when we start to feel pain. And all of a sudden your body says, hey, this is painful. I'm in pain. It hurts. Do something. So that is what kicks off that heat effect that we get from eating capsaicin.
All right, so I'm putting my red peppers, breadcrumbs, and the breadcrumbs kind of soak up some of the liquid from the peppers, about a cup of walnuts, some cumin here. So this is the freshly blended, and it smells really good. It smells just like roasted red peppers, basically. Okay, so now I'm gonna make the ghost pepper oil. And ghost pepper is supposed to be one of the spiciest peppers, but it does depend on both the soil, the climate, how you dry them. All of those things can affect the level of capsaicin in a pepper. So just because you see on Wikipedia that a pepper is super spicy doesn't mean that every pepper you eat of that kind is going to be the same amount of spicy. I will say one of the things that I preach a lot to people is that the dose makes the poison for pretty much anything, including like water or salt. So there is actually a toxicity limit for capsaicin. It can really, really like send you to the hospital. Okay, so I'm gonna taste my Aleppo oil and see what's up. So it's not very spicy, but it does have a really nice smokiness to it, which is nice.
Robin, you mentioned that a certain amount of capsaicin is lethal. So I decided to kind of find out how much. Apparently you need 12 to 13 grams for a 150 pound person.
That is a lot of capsaicin. To put that into perspective, so I did a quick lookup. A Carolina Reaper pepper is over 2 million Scoville units. That's the hottest pepper, right? The world record hottest pepper. And so if you need 15 grams of capsaicin to kill you, a single Carolina Reaper pepper is less than a gram.
All right, so I made my ghost pepper oil. So I'm gonna, it's a little hot, but I think I can give it a try.
What does it smell like?
It's like smoky. It doesn't smell too spicy. Like it doesn't smell like a hot sauce where it kind of singes your nostrils, but.
Oh no, Robin. get the stick of butter. A stick of
milk,
butter.
Cottage cheese.
I'm gonna add some to this Mohamra. I think it'll still work. But, Matt and Daisy, do you wanna talk about your recipes while I blow my nose?
Okay, so I am making chili infused honey. I've done this before and I used dried chili peppers. So these really, really, really small ones. I am gonna try using a different chili pepper. I think I wanna use this larger one. If the stem is short on a chili pepper, it's spicier than if you have a chili pepper that has like a longer stem. That the stem of this chili pepper, like if this was actually not dried, is definitely smaller than the stem of this one. So I'm going to be using dried peppers, and dried peppers, because they've been dehydrated, so they lack water. They are slightly spicier than if we just had regular chili peppers. So what I like to do is I like to kind of cut it up open.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So this part here, this top part is the placenta, and then you can't really see the veins unless like you really, really zoom in, but they travel all along the bottom.
Daisy, what kind of pepper is it?
Dried guajillo chili. I'm gonna just pour some in here. I want to kind of heat it up a little bit just to kind of like help that process to actually have the honey be infused with the spiciness. My little jar into the water and just kind of like let that warm up a bit. And it made the honey turn a little bit red. So it takes a while to kick in. And now I feel it. But I feel like I can keep eating this. It's actually just really good. So I've never tried just eating a dried piece of chili. I was kind of thinking this would be like my test of like how spicy it can be. So I'm just taking like a very, very small piece that has like the placenta part. And this actually kind of tastes sweet, which I'm actually surprised. Now the side of my mouth is like my cheek, my inside of the cheek is on fire.
All right, you two have been spicing things up. I feel like I should do my part here too and have some of my fried chili paste. But I flavored the oil using all sorts of aromatic ingredients. So garlic, shallots, star anise, Sichuan peppercorns, what else did I use? Cloves and cinnamon. To flavor the oil, I steeped all of those ingredients in hot oil for an hour and just let them sit for an hour. And so after I extracted all of those flavors into the oil, then I took that hot oil and I poured it over a bunch of chili flakes, crushed chilies. And so in doing that, right, the hot oil that goes in, it's bringing the flavors from all of the stuff that you steeped it with. But that hot oil then is going to extract both the capsaicin and other things from the chili flakes that you've got. So we can see how we did here. That's pretty good. So this one is a slow burn at the beginning also, but it will kick in. Yeah, that was, I ate a bit there.
So it reminds me a lot of like when I teach my students about, we make soap. And so soap has this fatty part and this part and another part that likes water. And so if we were to spill like oil on our hands and we use water, it's the oil's still gonna be stuck there. So we can imagine that like our hands are those like receptors or our tongue. And if I'm drinking water, it's still gonna stay there. But if I use soap, which has this kind of fatty part, the oil's gonna be trapped by those fatty liking long chains. And so it's gonna get trapped in there. So then when I'm washing my hands, it'll just wash away with it. And so I think that's kind of what happens when we have like milk, ice cream, cottage cheese, a stick of butter, right?
And if we're trying to get the capsaicin off of our tongues and into our, you know, saliva or whatever to wash it down our throats, it has to go into water. So there has to be something that brings it off of our tongue into that water. And so just like a soap will do with dirt, some of the molecules, whether it's ice cream or milk or butter, right? All these dairy things have them, right? They're called phospholipids. So anything with these phospholipids, so don't go drinking soap unless your mouth is really on fire. But something like that would work. We've talked a little bit about how we can get rid of that flavor, right? We've talked about dilution. Water is not the best idea. Water is to try to dilute it, but the capsaicin would rather be on your tongue than in the water and your saliva or whatever. And so drinking oil-based things or eating oily things is good for that. So milk, I'm gonna do milk. I'm gonna eat some butter because we talked about that in the lead up to this. So I'm gonna eat a little bit of butter. I'm gonna say that a little quietly so my wife can hear.
I'm gonna have some ice cream, which is my favorite way to cool down after I did something spicy.
I have cottage cheese. So I'm gonna like cleanse my palate with the cottage cheese. So cottage cheese has a lot of these like fatty, lipid, nonpolar molecules that are gonna kind of help wash away the capsaicin that's still around. It's surprising how little cottage cheese it took for me to like not feel like my mouth is spicy anymore. How's the ice cream working for you, Robin?
No, it's working pretty good. Yeah, but it is like the first effect is just the cold, the physical cold. And then it's like after your mouth warms back up again, you can kind of feel if there's burning still somewhere in there, but.
So kind of, that's kind of what the honey is doing. So honey has sugars, and sugars are these organic molecules. And so the sugar is also kind of encapsulating the capsaicin. And so we don't taste the spiciness as much. So I think that's one example of like how to tame the spiciness. So right, this doesn't have a stem, but it's really spicy.
Oh, no.
Oh gosh, I really do.
Well, I had a great time today. I think we've all survived. Our mouths are gonna live to tell the tale. And thank you to Daisy for being with us for the first time today. Hooray, it was wonderful. And thank you for everyone at home for watching along with us. We hope you go out and spice up your lives a little bit.
I definitely am gonna get on that honey chili. I have to try that. Once my temperature has gone back down in a week or so.